So in this session, we will talk about what is the inroad application, what we are using in tracker capture. And we will also demonstrate you how to install the inroad application in your device. Then we will see how to capture the data using the inroad application. The first thing we will be talking about is how to search the tracked entity instance in the inroad application. And then we will talk about how to register a new tracked entity. Then we will talk about the person's tracked entity dashboard that we have for the particular program. Then we will talk about how to enter the data for different events within a program stage. And then we see how to complete the enrollment within the system. And then we will talk about the relationships, how you can create the relationship between two different programs. And then we will see how to enroll a single tracked entity in multiple programs. And at the end, we will also talk about the offline data mode. So when I say Android application for DHIS2, this application is majorly being used as online and offline in both ways. So when I say offline, we only need the internet for two times. One is to log in into the application and then to sync the data into the server. Now, the introduction to Android application. This is the DHIS2 Android application is the mobile application basically to function smoothly with your DHIS2 instance. Now, this has different data models. One is the aggregate system, and then you have tracker programs and event programs. This works both on offline and online mode. And your metadata is automatically synced when you're using the offline mode whenever you're getting an internet access. Now we will first talk about how to install the application. So you all must have got this area where you have two different links to install the application. There are two different ways. One, you can install the application using the Google Play Store, and other one is the GitHub link that you have. So I'll demonstrate you how to install the application using the Google Play. And using this, the second link, you can install the application by GitHub as well. So please allow me 2 minutes to project my Android. I hope you all can see my screen now. Now I'll show you how to install the application using Google Play Store. You go to the Play Store, type DHIS2 capture, and then the second one. You can see the second application. Click on the application and install the application in your device. So once you install this application on your device, you will see on the application menu. Click on the application. You have to define your link, server URL, and then define your username and password. So once you define your username and password, click on login. Then this application will sync all the latest configurations and the data being entered. And now you will see an area where you will see all the three programs that you have in the system. So the very first thing that I will be explaining is how to actually search an existing tracked entity in the system. For that, select the second program, this one, COVID-19 case-based surveillance. And then you will see all the list of the beneficiaries already registered in the system. Now to search the existing beneficiary, you first need to go to the right hand side corner button. Click on this button. you will see an area where there are some fields defined already, which you can use and search an existing record. You can define anything from these fields. I will define the first name. And click on search button. So once you click on the search button on the right hand side corner, you will see the system will project you the existing beneficiaries already registered. You can click on the beneficiary and then the system will take you to the dashboard page of the existing beneficiary. Now you see within the COVID-19 case-based surveillance program, you have different programs events. Now on the last area, you have four different widgets, four different areas. The first is the area where you can see all the program stages of that particular program. The second one will be the indicator area, the analytics area, where if you click, you will see the indicators defined for that particular beneficiary. And this part is the relationship area. If you have created any relationship for that particular beneficiary with two different programs, then you will see the relationship here, which I will be explaining later. And then the last part are the notes for that particular beneficiary you can create. Now we will go back to the dashboard. And if you want to check any existing profile information for that particular beneficiary, you can click on see details. This area will show you the profile information for that person. You will see the enrollment data, the person was enrolled at which date, the organization unit, and the coordinates for that person. Now, the second part is to see the registration details of the existing beneficiary. You click on this registration. You will see all the required information filled for that particular beneficiary already registered. Now, we will go back and see how to register a new beneficiary in the system. The same way, we will select our program. So once you make the selection, the same way you will see there is the same icon to search or to add the particular beneficiary. So the system will first ask you to search from the list just to avoid any duplication of the record in the system. So once you click on the search button, you will again see the area where you can define any of the field to search an existing beneficiary or add a new beneficiary. So first I will write my first name and then I will define my last name. So to add, I would first need to search the beneficiary if it is present already. I click on this search button. The system will show me that there is no existing beneficiary present in the system. Then I will click on this plus button on the right hand side corner and add a new beneficiary. Now, the same way we talked about in the tracker capture web, the same way we will define the organization unit first, where I want to register my beneficiary and then click on accept. Now I will have to define the enrollment date of the person. And then once you define your date, click on accept. Now my system will take me to a page where I would need to fill the registration information of the beneficiary. Now the first area will show me which organization unit and what was my registration date I entered and the latitude and longitude if I want to mention. And the second part will show me all the registration details I want to enter for the particular beneficiary. Now the first name and last name I have already defined. I'll define my date of birth. The system will automatically calculate the age, then define your country. Then address. Then your phone number. Once you enter all the details, you go to this right hand side corner, save button, click there. And then the system will show you at which organization unit you're entering the data. And if you want to update this, update the date of consultation and the organization unit, you can see in this part. So once I save the registration information, the system will directly take me to the first program stage of this particular beneficiary. And if you need to change the event date or the date of consultation, you can select from this calendar and change the date of the first event. Otherwise, if this looks fine, then you can click on update. Now, system will take me to the first program stage of this particular program, where the first section will define the clinical signs and symptoms. If there are any signs and symptoms present, you can select yes, and then define the symptoms date. If there's any fever or cough, then I will define the details for the next program state section, which is the pregnancy details. Once you fill the details of the pregnancy, we will talk about the underlying conditions. If there is any underlying condition, you can define in this section. Once you fill all the details, we will have the hospitalization section. If the person was hospitalized, then you define all the required details. You can search the hospital name from this hierarchy. And click accept. And then if the person was having an exposure risk, and if the person is having any travel history, then you define everything in this section. From here, you can select the country of exposure. Then the sign onset of the symptoms, which is already taken. Then, once you fill all the details of that particular section, you will also see the status of the information filled in this in all these sections. So I have filled 64% of the details in this section. Now you go to the right hand side corner, there will be a button to complete this form. When you click this button, you will have two different options. One is the finish and complete, and one is finish. So when I say finish and complete, if you are sure that you have filled all the information and you would not require to come back and edit the information in future, you can click on finish and complete. And if you would need to edit the record in future, then you can just click finish and go back to the menu. Okay, I will click on finish and complete. So once I do that, the system will automatically take me to the dashboard area where I will see that my clinical examination and diagnosis event is created for the beneficiary. Now the same way, you can add the lab request program stage by clicking on this plus button. You will see two different areas. One is to add a new program stage and one is to refer the person with this program stage to other facility, the same way we did for the web application. Now here I'll click on add new, and the system will show me if I want to edit the event date, the date of lab request. I can click here and edit the date accordingly, or else if I want to edit the organization unit, then also I can click here and edit the organization unit. So once you define your event date, you click on the next button on the right hand side corner. Now the system will take me to all the program state sections that I have for this particular program stage. Now in this section, the first thing will be asked is reason for testing the COVID-19. You select your reason. Then there are some skip logics applied. Accordingly, the specimen details you can define. And then you can define the test request details, which test was performed or requested. Now you see, I filled all the information. So I have the status as 100%. The system shows me that there are all the questions are being filled. And the same way, we will go down to the right hand side corner and click on this button. The same way, we will see finish and complete and finish. So I would click on finish and complete since I do not have any more information to be filled in future. And you will see my events are created for these two. Now, the same way, I can create another event for lab result and health outcomes. So I click on this button, and the same way I can define my report date for this particular program stage and click on next and fill all the information like we did for the previous stage. And then we can finish the stage. I hope it's clear. If you have any question, you can write in chat box. Now, if you want to see the detail of this person, again, the enrollment details, you can click on see details. This part, see details, and check on the profile details of this person. If you want to make any changes, you can do this. Otherwise, you can click on the save button. So this is how you register a new person in the system and create the multiple events that you have. And if you want to complete this whole enrollment, you can click on this right hand side area on the three dots. This will show you multiple options. Now I want to complete my enrollment of this particular person in this particular program. Then I click on this complete area. And once I click complete, my enrollment will be completed for this program. And if I want to enroll the same person in different programs, I will again go to this dot. Three dots on the right hand side corner. I will click on my program enrollments, and then I will see there are three different programs I can enroll. So from the case-based surveillance, I will enroll my program to contact registration follow-up. I will click on enroll. The system will ask me at which date you want to enroll the person. I'll select the enrollment date and click on accept. Then the system will ask me for the organization unit. Then you select your organization unit and click on accept. Now my person will be enrolled in two different programs. One is the case-based surveillance and another one is the contact registration and follow-up. The same way, if you want to edit the attribute information, the attributes of the particular person, then you can click on the attribute and edit the information and click on save, or else you can directly click on save. Now the system will take me directly to the program stage of my program. Now the same way, you fill up all the informations required here, relation with the case and the exposure assessments. And once you do that, the system will ask you for more information. Now, once you enter the data, you click on the save button. Now finish and complete the same way we did for the previous stages. And my person is enrolled in two different programs. One is the COVID-19 contact registration network, and the other one is the case-based surveillance. I hope it's fine till now. We can take a 5 minutes break and then we will move ahead with further details. Please feel free to ask any question if you have.
Hello, I've posted my question on the chat box.
Yes, so the URL will be same and the password for Android is already defined in the learner's guide that you have received. I hope you all have installed the application from the Play Store. If you're facing any issue to install the application, please let us know.
Sir, we still uninstalling the application.
You're unable to install the application?
Please, yeah. Just 3 minutes. Please.
Yeah, you're sure.
Thank you.
Please see, this is the icon which you will get on the Play Store to install the application. I hope you all are okay with the application.
Yes, it's ready.
Yeah, so username, password, and the link is already defined. Please check the chat. You will be able to see. Okay, so I see one comment. I'm using the above. Okay, so you're using the same username and password? I've shared the URL. Please use that. I hope now everybody is fine. We can start. Okay, so I'll display my screen. Yes, so till now we have gone through the registration part of the beneficiary into the program. Then we have filled the details of the program stages that we have for the program. And then we have seen how to enroll the person from one program to another. So I'll again quickly brief how we did that. I hope you all are fine with the Indoor application installed and logged in. Now, once you log in, you will see this page. We will have three different programs over here. The very first thing that we did was to look for an existing beneficiary in the system for the COVID-19 case-based surveillance program. So to do that, you click on the program. Once you click on the program, you will see the list of the beneficiaries registered in the system within this program. Now to search an existing program, you will see this search and plus button on the right-hand side corner. You click on this right-hand side corner button, then you enter the detail with which detail you want to search the person from the list. And once you type the detail, you click on this search button, and you will see the person already exists in the program. Once you click on the person, the system will take you to the dashboard part where you will see there are different program stages in this COVID-19 case-based surveillance. And you will also see an area to see the details, the registration details of that person who is already registered. And once you click on the see details, you will have two different areas where the enrollment details are defined, the case registration detail of that person, the organization unit at which the person was registered, and the coordinates. The second part is the registration details. Once you click on the registration part, you will see all the profile information entered for that person. So this is how you search an existing beneficiary in the system. The second part, what we did was to register a new beneficiary. Now to register a new beneficiary, you will again go back to the same page where you have three different programs defined. And to register, you will again select your program. Once you select your program, the same way you will go to the right-hand side corner, search and add button, this one, and click on this button. You will again see all the defined areas from which you can search or add a new person. So the system will first ask you to search so that you will not enter a duplicate record. Now to add one, I will type the name, the first name and the last name, and click on the search and plus button on the right-hand side corner. You see this button? This is to first search, and if the person is not present in the system, then you will add this person. Once you click, the system will tell you that the same person is not already present in the system. And then to add this person in the system, you will click on this plus button. And then you select your organization unit where you want to register. The enrollment date, the person will be enrolled in the system. The same way, you define your registration information and click on the save button once you define all these information. Once you define the registration information, the system will take you directly to the first program stage, that is the clinical examination and diagnosis of that person. And the system will also ask you to edit or enter the date of consultation. So depending upon the visit, you can select your date of consultation and define your organization. The organization unit will be same, which you defined while enrolling the person in the system, and then click on update. Same way, you will see all the program stages for this, for all the program stage sections for this particular program. And once you fill all the details, then you go to, once you fill all the section details, you go to the right hand side corner, save button, and click here. And then the system will ask you if you want to finish and complete or finish. So if you're sure that you would not need to come back and again edit the record, then you click on finish and complete. And if you would need some informations to be added in future, then you click on finish. So for now, we will click on finish and complete. So the system will show you the patient dashboard here. And like I told you already, you can add multiple events by clicking on this plus button. You have different events for this particular program. First, you enter the details for clinical examination and diagnosis. Then there is an area where you can define the lab request details. Then you define the lab results and health outcomes. So by when you click on this plus button, you can add this particular program stage. I also told you how to complete the enrollment. You click on the three dots on the right-hand side corner, and you will see an area from which you can complete this record. So once you click, the enrollment will be completed. And the same way, you can enroll this person to another program. You click on these three dots available on the right-hand side corner, where you will see the fourth option to program enrollments. Click here, you will see the list of other programs. And through this button, you can click on the program to enroll. So once you click on the enrollment button, the system will ask you for the enrollment date for that particular program. You select your enrollment date and click accept. Define your organization unit and accept this. And then the system will show you all the registration information that you filled while registering the person in the case-based surveillance program. So if you think that these information looks fine, then you can just directly click on save. Otherwise, if you want to edit this information, you can select the field and edit, and then click on save button on the right hand side corner. Now my person is enrolled in both the programs. One is the case-based surveillance and one is the registration and follow-ups. Now, if you go back, then you will see the dashboard page for that particular program, the contact registration and follow-up. Now, if you click on these three dots, you will be able to see your person also enrolled in your case-based surveillance program. So through this, you can see that your person is enrolled in two different programs. Now, if you want to create a relationship between two different programs, you have this area, registration, the same way, like in web, you create relationship. In Android also, you can create a relationship between two different programs. So if you think that the contact, the person came in contact, then you select, and then you click on the plus button. Has been in contact, then the system will take you to the list of the beneficiaries already registered in the system. And through this list, you can select your person or you can go to this area, select, define your particular program where you want to create the relationship. And once you define, the system will filter all the beneficiaries registered in this program and then select your beneficiary. And now this the relationship will be created with this beneficiary and between two different programs, contact registration and follow-up and case-based surveillance. Now we will go back to the dashboard part. And you can switch anytime to different programs by these three dots. And you can directly go to the other program using this area. Now, since this is in both offline and online data entry, so you can register your person without internet connection. Once you log in using the internet connection, you can register the person into the system without the internet connection. And then when you get the access of the internet connection, the data will be synced to the server and you will have your record permanently in the system. So now I'll tell you how to sync your data manually, how to send the data. You go back, click on this arrow. Go back to this place. You will see there is a gray, there are two different gray areas. This shows that the data is only present in my device, not on the server. So to send this data, you click on this, these two arrow. This will show you the data is stored in your device, only it is not synced with the server. So this is one way you can send the data only for the record that you have entered. Click on the send button. And now this will turn, the gray arrow will turn into green. That means the record you entered is now being, is now sent to the server and not only present in your device, but also on the server. So this is one part where, how you can sync the data. This, if you want to sync only the enrollment that you have made, then you use this. And if you want to sync multiple registrations, then we have another area how to sync. Till now, if you have any question, we can take those questions or any doubt. Then we will talk about the syncing part. Okay, so I see a comment takes a while to sync. Yeah, that depends on the internet connection that you have. If you have installed the application, please try from your end. Try to register a person. And then enter the details of all the events that you have. And then try to sync the data. Any question till now?
I typically just take a moment to show the word of the day. Just give me a minute. Sure. Everyone, the word of the day is Vaxzevria. It's one of the vaccines being used in the European region. So just spell it as it is, V capital, rest all small. And please make sure you mark your attendance for today on Moodle. I've also added this on the Zoom chat as well, and then it's currently on your screen as well. Please do mark your attendance for today. Yeah, Deepika, you can proceed.
Yeah. I hope it's clear for all of you, and I hope you're not facing any error while logging into the application. Let's proceed further. So now we will see how to sync the whole, the bulk entries that we have in the system. Till now we have seen how to sync the particular program you registered the beneficiary in. And if you have registered 10, for example, you have registered 10 beneficiaries in the system, and if you want to sync all the data, then you have another area which you can define. Go to this three lines on the left hand side corner. Click on these three lines. You will see this area. Click on setting. So once you click on setting, you will see there are different options. The first one is sync data. So from this area, you can sync the data manually. Click on sync data. Once you click, the system will show you that all the tracked entity which you have entered in the system are being synced. And the system will also show you the status. In this area, you will see that the last synchronization was done at 13, 12, 26, 10. And once you sync your data, you go back to home page. Now you will see that all the beneficiaries registered in the system are synced to server, and you will be able to see those records in the web version. We also have another option on the right-hand side corner from which you can filter your record from the list. You can filter your record using the event date. You can filter your record using the registration date, your organization unit. You can define your particular organization unit at which you want to see your person. You can also see how many records are synced in the system. And through the enrollment status, if the person is active or the record is completed or canceled. Then you have event status, if the event is scheduled or if you have any open event, you can filter the records. And then there are more options to follow up with the person. We have features in the Android application. Now we will check the records we have entered in using the Android application, if they are available on the web application. We'll log in using the same username and password, and then we go to the Tracker Capture application from the application menu. Then select your organization unit. Or you can directly you can select your program, and then you will see multiple records being registered in the system. You can directly see from the list, or you can search from the search button. Let's say we entered the record for Tim Curry and then click on search. The person is registered in the system for case-based surveillance and the contact registration and follow-up. So this is how you register the person using the Android application, sync your data, and then the person will be enrolled and the data will be sent to the server. I hope till now it's clear for all of you. Please feel free to ask any question you have regarding the application. So you have to be very sure while you, we also have an area which is logout. So you have to be very sure that you have synced all your data into the server before you log out it from the application. If you will not sync your data to the server and log out without syncing it, then you will lose your data entered on your device. So you have to be very sure that you sync all your data and you have the internet connection before you log out. I hope it's clear for all of you. We can move ahead. Any question till now? Okay. So now we have seen how to register the person when we have the internet connection. The last is to explore the offline mobile data, mobile application. So what we will do, we will switch off the internet connection. And once we do, sorry. So once you switch off the internet connection, you will be able to register the person in the system, but you will not be able to sync the data into the server. What you'll do, you will click on the registration program, the vaccine registration program. The same way, you will go to the right hand side corner, select your search or add button. Once you do that, you will have different areas to define to search the beneficiary from the system or to add a new one. Define your beneficiary. Click on search button, the system will. Show you that the record is not present in the system, and then click on the plus button, the same way define your organization unit and click accept. Define your program attributes. Click on save button, and then you will see the dashboard part. So the same workflow will be followed with the offline version, like you did during the online version. So once you get the internet connection, that all the details you filled here will be synced to the server, and then only you can log out from the enrolled application. Before that, if you log out, you will lose all your data. So this arrow shows me that the record I entered is not yet synced with the server. And once you get the internet connection, you can click on this arrow and send this data to the server. And your data will be synced to the server. Any doubt, any question till now?
Excuse me. Hello.
Yes, please.
I can't log into the app. I don't know. There's an error coming always. Is it tracker capture? Isn't it that?
Yeah, it is DHIS capture application on Play Store.
DHIS capture.
Yeah, right.
Okay.
Please try from your end to register or to search an existing beneficiary and to edit the detail or to add a new program stage and try to sync the data. I hope you all are able to log in and you can register the person. So if you understand the workflow for tracker capture, the programs and the program stages and the program sections, then the Android application is very easy for you to understand. I request you all to please enter one record or two records and then just let us know if you're facing any difficulties or any issue or you have any question. Try to register a person and then enroll in different programs, create different program events. Okay, so I see devices still syncing after logging in. If you're facing issue after logging in, then try to clear the application cache from the app information and try again entering the username and password.
Okay, everyone. So with this, we come to the end of the day two of our academy. So there are a few tasks that you have to complete by the end of the day, probably. So first thing is, today we had a few graded assignments. So we have two graded assignments, one for the web tracker capture and the next one for the Android capture. And then please kindly fill the feedback. So feedback we have now, each day we have feedback. I assume there were a few of you who could not fill the feedback for yesterday's session. So please do that, because on daily basis, we go through the feedback and we try to improve ourselves. So please fill the feedback for both the days. And also, in case if you encounter any issues while doing the questions or if you want to go through the video again, if you have any issues, please ask them on Slack. We will answer them on the Slack itself so that it'll be visible to everyone. And also, please mark the attendance. We have already mentioned the word of the day. So that's all what we need you to do, and see you tomorrow, same time, 12 noon Indian Standard Time. Have a good day. Bye-bye.